Old Testament, Exodus 1 through 3. These are the names of the son of Israel who came to Egypt with Jacob, each with his household: Reuben, Simeon, Levi, and Judah; Issachar, Zebulun, and Benjamin; Dan, Naphtali, Gad, and Asher. All the offspring of Jacob were 70 people. Joseph was already in Egypt. Then Joseph died, and all his brothers, and all that generation. But the descendants of Israel were fruitful and increased greatly. They multiplied and grew increasingly strong, so that the land was filled with them. The Israelites are oppressed. Now there arose a new king over Egypt who did not know Joseph. And he said to his people, "Behold, the people of Israel are too many and too mighty for us. Come, let us deal shrewdly with them, lest they multiply and a war befall on us. They join our enemies and fight against us and escape from our land." Therefore they set taskmasters over them to afflict them with heavy burdens. And they built for the Pharaoh store cities, Pithom and Ramesses. But the more they were oppressed, the more they multiplied and the more they spread about. And the Egyptians were in the dread of the people of Israel. So they made the people of Israel serve with rigor, and made their lives bitter in hard service, in mortar and brick, and in all kinds of work in the field. In all their work, they made them serve with rigor. Then the king of Egypt said to the Hebrew midwives, one of whom was named Sifra, and the other Pulah, "When you serve as a midwife to the Hebrew women, and see upon the birth stool, if it is a son, you shall kill him, but if it is a daughter, she shall live." But the midwives feared God, and they did not do as the king commanded them, but let the male children live. So that the king of Egypt called their midwives, and said to them, "Why have you done this, and let the male and children live?" The midwives said to the Pharaoh, "Because the Hebrew women are not like the Egyptian women, for they are vigorous and delivered before the midwives come to them." So God dealt well with the midwives, and the people multiplied and grew very strong. And because the midwives feared God, he gave them families. Then the Pharaoh commanded all his people and said, "Every son that is born to the Hebrews you shall cast into the Nile, but you shall let every daughter live." The birth and childhood of Moses. Now, a man from the house of Levi went and took for a wife a daughter of Levi. The woman conceived and bore a son. And when she saw that he was a goodly child, she hid him for 3 months. And when she could no longer hide him, she made a basket for him out of bulrushes and daubed it with bitumen and pitch. And she put the child in it and placed it among the reeds at the river's brink. And his sister stood at a distance to know what would happen to him. Now the daughter of the Pharaoh came down to bathe at the river, and her maidens walked beside the river. She saw the basket among the reeds and sent her maids to fetch it. When she opened it, she saw that it was a child, and lo, the baby was crying. She took pity on him and said, "This is one of the Hebrews' children." Then his sister said to the Pharaoh, "Shall I go and call your nurse from the Hebrew women to nurse the child for you?" And the Pharaoh's daughter said to her, "Go." So the girl went and called the child's mother. And the Pharaoh's daughter said to her, "Take this child away and nurse him for me, and I will give you your wages." So the woman took the child and nursed him. And the child grew, and she brought him to the Pharaoh's daughter, and he became her son, and she named him Moses. For she said, "Because I drew him out of the water." Moses flees to Midian. One day when Moses had grown up, he went out to his people and looked on the burdens. And he saw an Egyptian beating a Hebrew, one of his people. He looked this way and that, and seeing no one, he killed the Egyptian and hid him in the sand. When he went out the next day, behold, two Hebrews were struggling together. And he said to the man that did wrong, "Why did you strike your fellow?" He answered, "Who made you prince and judge over us? Do you mean to kill me as you killed the Egyptian?" Then Moses was afraid and thought, "Surely the thing is known." When the Pharaoh heard of it, he sought to kill Moses. But Moses fled from the Pharaoh and stayed in the land of Midian. And he sat down by a well. Now the priest of Midian had 7 daughters, and filled their troughs with water for their father's flock. When they came to their father Reuel, he said, "How is it that you have come in so soon today?" They said, "An Egyptian delivered us out of the hand of the shepherds, and even drew water for us and watered the flock." He said to his daughters, "And where is he? Why have you left the man? Call him that he may eat some bread." And Moses was content to dwell with the man, and he gave Moses his daughter Zipporah, and she bore a son, and he called his name Gershom, for he said, "I have been a sojourner in a foreign land." In the course of those many days, the king of Egypt died, and the people of Israel groaned under their bondage, and cried out for help, and their cry under bondage came up to God. And God heard their groaning, and God remembered his own covenant with Abraham, with Isaac, and with Jacob. And God saw the people of Israel, and God knew their condition. Moses at the burning bush. Now Moses was keeping the flock of his father-in-law, Jethro, the priest of Midian, and he led his flock to the west side of the wilderness. And he came to Horeb, the mountain of God. And the angel of the Lord appeared to him in a flame of fire out of the midst of a bush. And he looked, and lo, the bush was burning, yet it was not being consumed. And Moses said, I will turn aside and see this great sight, why the bush is not burnt. When the Lord saw that he had turned aside to see, God called him from out of the bush and said, Moses, Moses. And he said, Here I am. Then he said, Do not come near. Put off your shoes from your feet, for the place on which you are standing is holy ground. And he said, I am the God of your father, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob. And Moses hid his face as he was afraid to look at God. Then the Lord said, I have seen the affliction of my people who are in Egypt, and have heard their cry because of the taskmasters. I know their suffering, and I have come down to deliver them out of the hand of the Egyptians and bring them up out of the land to the good and broad land, a land flowing with milk and honey, to the place of the Canaanites, the Hittites, and the Amorites, and the Perizzites, the Hivites, and the Jebusites. And now, behold, the cry of the people of Israel has come to me, and I have seen the oppression which with the Egyptians oppressed them with. Come, and I will send you to Pharaoh, that you may bring forth my people, the sons of Israel, out of Egypt. Moses said to God, Who am I that I should go to the Pharaoh and bring the sons of Israel out of Egypt? He said, But I will be with you, and this shall be the sign for you that I have sent you. When you have brought forth the people out of Egypt, you shall serve God upon this mountain. The divine name revealed. Then Moses said to God, If I come to the people of Israel and say to them, The God of your fathers has sent me to you, and they ask me, What is his name? What shall I say to them? God said to Moses, I am who I am. And he said, Say this to the people of Israel, I am has sent me to you. God also said to Moses, Say this to the people of Israel, The Lord, the God of your fathers, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob has sent me to you. This is my name forever, and thus I am to be remembered throughout all the generations. Go and gather the elders of Israel together and say to them, The Lord, the God of your fathers, the God of Abraham, of Isaac, and of Jacob has appeared to me, saying, I have observed you and what has been done to you in Egypt, and I promise that I will bring you up from the affliction of Egypt to the land of the Canaanites, the Hittites, the Amorites, the Perizzites, the Hivites, and the Jebusites, a land flowing with milk and honey. And they will hearken to your voice, and you and the elders of Israel shall go to the king of Egypt and say to him, The Lord, the God of the Hebrews, has met with us, and now we pray you, let us go on a 3 days journey into the wilderness, that we may sacrifice to the Lord our God. I know that the king of Egypt will not let you go unless compelled by a mightier hand. So I will stretch out my hand and smite Egypt with all the wonders which I will do in it, and after that he will let you go. And I will give this people favor in the sight of the Egyptians, and when you go you shall not go empty. But each woman shall ask of her neighbor and of who sojourns in her house, jewelry of silver and of gold, and clothing, and you shall put them on your sons and your daughters, thus you shall despoil the Egyptians. New Testament, Matthew 14, verses 1 through 21. The death of John the Baptist. At that time, Herod the Tetrarch heard about the fame of Jesus and said to his servants, This is John the Baptist, he has been raised from the dead, that is why these powers are at work in him. For Herod seized John and bound him and put him in prison, for the sake of Herodias, his brother Philip's wife, because John said to him, It is not lawful for you to have her. And although he wanted to put him to death, he feared the people because they held him to be a prophet. But when Herod's birthday came, the daughter of Herodias danced before the company and pleased Herod, so that he promised with an oath to give her whatever she might ask. Prompted by her mother, she asked, Give me the head of John the Baptist here on a platter. And the king was sorry, but because of his oath and his guest, he commanded it to be given. He sent and had John beheaded in the prison, and his head was brought on a platter and given to the girl, and she brought it to her mother. And his disciples came and took the body and buried it, and they went and told Jesus. The feeding of the 5,000. Now when Jesus heard of this, he withdrew from there in the boat to a lonely part apart. But when the crowds heard it, they followed him on foot from the towns. As he went ashore, he saw a great throng, and he had compassion for them and healed their sick. When it was evening, the disciples came to him and said, This is a lonely place, and the day is now over. Send the crowds away and go into the village and buy food for themselves. But Jesus said, They need not to go away. You give them something here to eat. And they said to him, We only have 5 loaves of bread and 2 fish. And he said, "Bring them here to me." Then he ordered the crowds to sit down on the grass, and taking the 5 loaves and the 2 fish, he looked up to heaven and blessed and broke them and gave the loaves to the disciples. And the disciples gave them to the crowds, and they all ate, and they were all satisfied. And they took up the 12 baskets full of broken pieces left over, and those who ate were about 5,000 men, besides women and children. Thank you for listening. God bless you. And if you want to continue, subscribe and have a great day.